On behalf of the family of Wayne Bottmueller, thank you for being here as we honor his life, his legacy, and most importantly, his faith in Jesus Christ as we find comfort this morning, knowing that he is with his Savior, Jesus. And as we celebrate and honor the life and legacy of our brother in Christ, Wayne, I invite you to stand for opening hymn number 801. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. In holy baptism, Wayne was clothed with the robe of Christ's righteousness that covered all his sin, St. Paul says, "Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, in order that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his." The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God of grace and mercy, we give thanks for your loving kindness shown to Wayne and to all your servants who, having finished their course in faith, now rest from their labors. Grant that we also may be faithful unto death and receive the crown of eternal life through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The congregation may be seated for the scripture readings.
The first reading is from Revelation 21, verse 3 through 6. "And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, 'Behold, the dwelling place of God is with man. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people, and God himself will be with them as their God. He will wipe away every tear from the eyes, and death shall be no more. Neither shall there be mourning, nor crying, nor pain anymore. For the former things have passed away.' And he who is seated on the throne said, 'Behold, I am making all things new.' Also he said, 'Write this down, for these words are trustworthy and true.' And he said to me, 'It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give from the spring of water of life without payment.' This is the word of the Lord."
Second reading, Romans 8, 38 and 39. "For I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels nor rulers, nor things present, nor things come, nor powers, nor height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord." This is the word of the Lord.
Please stand for the reading of the Holy Gospel. Jesus said to them, "Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to be with myself, that where I am, you may be also. And you know the way to where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." This is the word of the Lord. You may be seated.
Sarah of the Father will never capture you.
Dear friends and family and brothers and sisters in Christ, my hope and prayer for you today comes from St. Paul's words in Philippians chapter 4, where he writes, "And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus." One of the greatest encouragements into my life and into my faith was knowing and getting to have conversations with Wayne. Through all of his cancer and through all of his kidney and all of his eye difficulties and all the sickness and all the difficult circumstances he faced, every time I met with him, he never once complained. It was amazing, right, Donna? Never once complained. Every time we met together, he would just say, "Well, God's got a plan." Or he would say, "God's got it. It's in God's timing." Every single time, every single conversation we had together, he always lifted it up to God in prayer and showed his faith, his remarkable faith that encouraged me in my own life, and I'm sure for many of you as well, saying, "Nope, God's in control, and God's got this." One of his favorite things to say to me was, "It's in his hands." This reminds me of Paul writing a promise in Romans chapter 8, where he says, "For I'm sure that neither death nor life, nor angels nor rulers, nor things present nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation, not kidney failure, not blindness, not cancer, will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord." That's a promise that God made to Mr. Wayne each and every day of his life and has made to him and kept for him even now as he has brought him home to heaven. And it's a promise that Wayne trusted in every single day of his life. He knew without a shadow of a doubt that God loved him with a perfect love. Wayne not only expressed his faith by trusting in God through difficult circumstances, he expressed his faith by being the kind of guy that would give you the shirt off his back. And Don and I joked that he quite literally did that because not a single time I visited him did he wear a shirt. He just always sat in his bathrobe and said, "Here I am." But he really would have given you the shirt off his back if you needed it. In fact, one time while they were driving home, he saw a man on the street who needed a winter coat, and Wayne pulled over and stopped and gave him his coat and then looked at Don and said, "I think we need to go to Walmart because I need a new coat." The family would like me to ask you to honor Wayne in this way with Wayne's challenge by keeping gloves in your car during the winter and giving them to those you see in need that are cold during these difficult months. But Wayne was a man who trusted in the love of God, and he was a man who expressed the love of God by helping those in need, no matter what it meant for him. One of the most famous ways that Wayne expressed his faith was by playing John the Baptist here at Our Savior for many years and shouting, "Prepare the way of the Lord," and probably scaring more people than he encouraged. But he did it anyway, and he did it with vigor and gusto and energy, only the way Mr. Wayne could. But it reminds me of this promise in John chapter 14, where Jesus says, "Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God and believe also in me." And Wayne really believed that promise. He believed in God, and therefore his heart was not troubled. Instead, he spent his life preparing the way for the Lord, preparing for hearts and minds to know the love of God and the love of his Savior, Jesus. Jesus goes on in John chapter 14, "In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, that where I am, you may be also." As amazing as it was that Wayne helped people be prepared for Jesus by playing John the Baptist, giving the shirt off his back, or trusting God's promises even in the most difficult of life circumstances, Wayne spent his life pointing people to Jesus, helping them to look to Jesus. However, a greater promise is that Jesus prepared the way home for Wayne. Through faith in Jesus Christ, through the death and resurrection of Jesus, he prepared a way home into heaven for Wayne. And Wayne trusted in that promise and finds his hope and his now eternal life in that promise that he is with his Savior Jesus. Jesus has welcomed him home to the place he prepared for him. And because of this, we have this promise from Revelation chapter 21. "I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, 'Behold, the dwelling place of God is with man. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people. And God himself will be with them as their God.'" That is true reality for Wayne today. He is with God, and God is with him on the throne of heaven, rejoicing with all the saints that have gone before. And our promise and our hope and our comfort today is trusting those same promises that God made to Wayne and that Wayne trusted throughout all of his life. That God loves you with a perfect love, that there is nothing that will separate you from that love of Jesus, that he has prepared a way home to heaven for you to be with him and Wayne and all the saints that have gone before. And this final promise where he will make all things new. Revelation 21 says, "He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and death shall be no more. Neither shall there be mourning, nor crying, nor pain anymore. For the former things have passed away." And he who is seated on the throne said, "Behold, I am making all things new." Jesus kept that promise for Wayne today. He has wiped away all of his tears. He has gotten rid of death for Wayne, and he has made all things new and given him the promise of eternal life. And our hope and comfort today, as we have tears, as we have grief and sorrow, is trusting in those promises that one day God will wipe them away from our face, and he will make all things new along with us and Wayne and all the saints that have gone before him. And this is what Jesus says, "Write this down, for these words are trustworthy and true." My hope and prayer for you today is that you would honor Wayne's faith and legacy by trusting in those words of Jesus, that they are trustworthy and true, just like they were for Wayne throughout his life. And he gave us such an amazing example in so many ways of trusting those promises, that today you would find comfort and hope in trusting the promises of Jesus, that he's made a way home for Wayne, he has made a way home for you, and for all of us, he is making all things new. Amen. I invite you to stand or kneel for the prayers of the church. Let us pray to the Lord our God and Father, who raised Jesus from the dead. Almighty God, you have knit your chosen people together into one communion in the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and peace. Lord, in your mercy, grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to newness of life, and so pass with him through the gate of death and the grave to our joyful resurrection. Lord, in your mercy, give to the family of Wayne and to all who mourn comfort in their grief and assure confidence in your loving care, that casting all their sorrow on you, they may know the consolation of your love. Lord, in your mercy, give courage and faith to the bereaved, that within the communion of your church, they may have strength to meet the days ahead in the assurance of a holy and certain hope and the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love who have departed in the faith. Lord, in your mercy. Help us, we pray, in the midst of things we cannot understand, to believe and find comfort in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Lord, in your mercy. Receive our thanks for Wayne and for all the blessings you bestowed on him in this earthly life. Bring us at last to our heavenly home, that with him we may see you face to face in the joys of paradise. Lord, in your mercy. O God of all grace, who sent your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, to bring life and immortality to light, we give you thanks that by his death he destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection he opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Strengthen us in the confidence that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, will be able to separate us from your love, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The congregation may be seated. Shepherd, you gather the lambs of your flock into the arms of your mercy and bring them home. Comfort us with a certain hope of the resurrection to everlasting life and a joyful reunion with those we love who have died in the faith. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Almighty God, by the death of your Son, Jesus Christ, you destroyed death. By his rest in the tomb, you sanctified the graves of your saints, and by his bodily resurrection, you brought life and immortality to light, so that all who die in him abide in peace and hope. Receive our thanks for the victory over death and the grave that he won for us. Keep us in everlasting communion with all who wait for him on earth, and with all in heaven who are with him now. For he is the resurrection of the life, even Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. Lord, make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. Lord, look upon you with favor and give you his peace. Amen. I invite the congregation to stand for our closing hymn number 677.